came out here thinking that I was going to need to announce that the microphone wasn't working, but Candide woke it up. And grateful that that's working. So, good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you so much for being here. My name is Rob Davis. I'm one of the conductors of this awesome ensemble. We want to welcome you and thank you for your attendance tonight. If you could take just a moment, if you haven't done so already, and be sure to turn off your phones or any other devices you might have with you as you walk during the show, we'd be very grateful. The first piece we just performed for you is the Overture Candide by Leonard Bernstein, and we'll proceed in our program by inviting another conductor, the principal conductor of this group, Dan Schmidt, out to perform the Alfred Symphony. Thanks so much again for your attendance.
Take all those spots down appreciably, and then we'll continue. And as we're waiting for the lights to come down, let me tell you, a symphony in music, the large instrumental form is referred to as the symphony. It's the longest piece of music that audiences listen to, except if you're going to opera. Grand opera is the largest. You can have 4-hour operas. We can have symphonies that take over an hour and 30 minutes. And so Brahms, for example, the very famous romantic composer Brahms, for many years he wouldn't write a symphony. And the reason he wouldn't write it is Beethoven's symphonies were very fresh in the ears of most audiences at Brahms' time. And he could just hear Beethoven's symphonies in his ear, and it unnerved him. He wasn't prepared to compose of the large-scale work. So we're going to play a symphony. It's not that long. I think it's over 20 minutes. So for the next 20 minutes, if you need to use the restroom, you might want to use it now. 20-minute work, three substantial movements, and the movements are full of emotion. And the first emotion is, I wrote it on my score so I wouldn't forget it. Profound. the second movement is one of the most beautiful slow movements in all of the band repertoire. And I'm old, I know that. And the third movement is just it's written in 4-4, but it's halfway between a march and an overture. But it's a fun third movement. But all three movements are rather drawn out. So listen patiently and forbearing. And I think you're really going to like this. We're going to like it better, but we can't start it until we get those lights taken care of. So house manager, if you're in up there, we need to have you change the light. Not brighter. Maybe something that just
show them off.
Solo spot on me.
Is
Nobody works here.
You know what? I have an idea. House manager, would you turn on the house lights? That means, yes, right. And now you can turn down those lights that are spots. The spots. No, don't. Keep the house lights on. Just turn down it. Man, is this better?
No.
Stage lights, they need to watch the music. Lights on stage. The work lights which we have for rehearsal today. We've been in this room a lot today. We came in at 9:15. This could be worse, but one January concert, there was a fire. Fire alarms went off, and so we had to cancel the concert. Another one was heavy snow, and they canceled the concert. If you were coming up from Portland, which many in the group come from Portland, we didn't know until this morning whether the roads would be icy or not. We just need more stage lights, not more lights pointed to the stage, but more stage work lights. Work lights, stage. This is killing the mood for this profound first move.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Just for that, we're going to take an intermission.
You're welcome to visit the goodies out in the lobby area as provided by our Rochester Busy Boosters. Be kind in your giving to them because they need all the help. All of the school groups can use all of that help. Thanks for coming out. We'll see you in just a little bit. Right back here. Don't go away.
Very fun, very exciting piece with all kinds of great jazz rhythms in here that represent a lot of different cultures. And if you're familiar with West Side Story, you're going to recognize a lot of these fun tunes. And if you're not, then we think you'll really enjoy it. And maybe it will inspire you to go and check out that musical in its original form or perhaps its later adapted forms. But in either case, we hope you really enjoy these symphonic dances from West Side Story by Leonard.
Thank you. Thank you.
sixth piece of music. I'd like to fill you in on just a little bit of background on it, because I think it'll mean more to you if you understand where it came from. There's some terrific program notes that tell you about the background for the hymn tune that forms the core of the development that Elliot del Borgo created with this piece of music. What it does not tell you is why that piece was selected as the basis for a symphonic paraphrase. To understand that, I'm going to read you the cover of the director's score. The commission for symphonic paraphrase is the result of an outpouring of love by family and friends for Robert Robbie King, a vital and enthusiastic 18-year-old who was tragically killed in a skiing accident in 1994. He was a devoted Christian whose love of music was second only to his love for his Lord. Members of his church often heard the mellow tones of Robbie's trumpet as he played his favorite hymn, "It Is Well With My Soul." Robbie, shortly before his accident, had given a testimony as to his faith, and he was also recorded playing this hymn. When the accident happened and the outpouring of love from the community came in with many, many financial contributions, and the family came to us and said, what do you recommend? And I said, you know, it's really terrific when something like this happens to have a commission for a new piece of band music. I think Robbie would like that. And so we contracted with Elliot del Borgo, and he composed this for us, and came out actually for the world premiere performance, and conducted the Northwest Wind Symphony in that world premiere performance. It just so happened that year we also had been selected to perform at the Western International Band Clinic, and so as a band we took a road trip and went to that clinic. I was privileged to get to conduct that performance of it. Carol and Diane, our conductor at the time, played in the trumpet section for that performance on Robbie's trumpet. And it was just a very meaningful time for this piece. The words of the hymn not only speak to what Horatio Spafford was writing about back in the 1800s when he composed, when he wrote the words for this piece, they speak to Robbie's testimony. "When peace like a river attendeth my way, when sorrows like sea billows roll, whatever my lot, thou hast taught me to say, it is well with my soul." We hope you enjoy Symphony Paraphrase.
Thank you.
I'm going to ask if we have the house lights up for this entire last piece. Is it possible to bring the house lights up but leave the stage the way it is? If it is, then that would be nice. There we go. Thank you. We thank you for coming. I've often said this, we would have played this concert even if there were no audience here. But we thank you for coming. Thank you especially for coming. You gentlemen with the red shirt and the... Well, right behind you, sir, there's another gentleman with black hair. Right there. Thank you very much for coming. Not that we haven't played this entire concert for you, but we want to play especially this last number for you. And it's called Wind Sprints. And we don't want you to wind sprint out and drive home, but drive carefully as you go home. And you guys drive very carefully, especially if you're going south. You're driving in rain the whole way. Thanks for coming again, and we really look forward to seeing you April the 20th. April the 20th. Thank you.